Personally, ideal leadership to me means naturally the person have the power, the ability to influence people to get things done, get things moving on their own, right? And I think currently this is still lacking in the organization.
I think currently we are working towards the ideal leaderships. We are not longer, you know, in the traditional way of running the business or being a manager, but or being a leader, but we are being trained how to, you know, follow the latest trend, how to work with different generations of people, and we become more dynamic.
Definitely no. Well, I think there's a distinct difference between a manager and a leader. You know, manager, their main responsibility is to getting good control of, you know, the resources that are handed to them. Yeah, a leader actually sets the direction.
Yes, it's important, especially what we have learned from this time leadership conference. We get to know what's different of being a leader and what's the difference of being a manager. So of course everybody has to be a leader in order to make this company a more healthy organization.
Leaders and followers should complement each other. You know, they should come hand in hand. Without the followers, the leaders cannot excel. Without the leaders, the followers can't go any further as well. Yeah.
There's a very close interaction between leaders and followers. Well, it's just like day and night. You know, they have different characteristics, they have different roles. Without each other, they cannot exist. So I think it's still important to have, you know, both in place to get a certain task done.
Phrase would be lead by example.
I would say it's influence.
I would say it's charisma.
Trust and